Hello everybody, this is Roving Shadow. I am back with more Quests for Glory 4, Shadows of Darkness. Last time I left off here in the Adventurers Guild, I was going to practice my climbing, however, this is quite a bit slower than somewhere else I could be practicing, but I have to wait until night, and I don't want to waste a whole day just for that. So I will practice climbing some other time. There's plenty of other things that we could be doing, so... And actually, first thing, we could come right in here. And...
Hello? Do you have any news?
No, but I very well may have a question. Let's first greet her.
So, you haven't been eaten yet? We'll see how long you last traipsing about everywhere when you should be staying in this nice, safe town.
Nice? I beg to differ.
Tell Olga about what you've been doing in Mordavia.
Be sure and keep me informed. I need to know everything that goes on around here. Someone's got to have a clue after all.
Okay. And I also can't remember if we actually... any of those were already said, but... let's...
My sad departed husband. His name was Boris.
Yes, we know
3 years now.
Boris Stovey.
Such a...
unfortunately, I guess it doesn't... Oh, okay, now we can tell about gatekeeper.
You tell Olga that the gatekeeper's name is Boris Stovich, and ask if they're related.
Aha! So that's where the so-and-so went. Tell him he's a rotten old goodnik.
Eh, that's not very nice. That's not nice at all.
Good night, and don't let the bedbugs bite, as my husband used to say.
For him being such a no-good whatever, you seem to like his phrases for some strange reason. No, I'm gonna grab...
You already have...
I can't grab any more. Okay. Well, we will be walking by the castle so we can drop off that little message. And then there's something else I want to do. So let's head up here. What does he have to say this time?
Welcome again. It is so good to speak with you as always. The woods around here seem almost frightening at times. When you arrive, I know it is only my imagination that makes me nervous.
Okay, let's say hello.
It is so difficult to get past the swamp which blocks the pass to and from the valley. We haven't had a stranger here since the rains created the swamp several years ago.
As I've heard. Let's tell about ourselves.
You've obviously done quite...
Okay, so that's the same. Let's tell about Olga.
Tell Boris what Olga said about him. He blushes.
Olga was always opinionated. I grew tired of listening to her complain about me all the time.
I understand. Did you say anything different? Ask about wife.
My wife has been gone for many years now.
Okay, I'm willing to bet these all say the same
this
thing.
This is the...
Yeah, these all say the same thing, so next time we go into...
Farewell, and may your path lead to your goal.
Okay, thank you. Next time we're in town, we'll have to talk to Olga again. And, yeah. So now, I am going to head back to the lake, in which I also remember we actually need to look at things. So, okay.
You have a strange, disquieting...
Okay, and that's the same.
Hello there. Could you help me? This water is so...
And I believe that's the same thing as what was said before, so...
A hint of clear blue sky is visible above the treetops.
Let's just go and look at
the tall
things.
Trees of the forest line the northern horizon, like sentinels loyally guarding their posts. You can see a reflection of some of the trees and sky in the crystal-clear lake water. A tall tree intrudes from the nearby forest. Lily pads float serenely on the surface of the lake. A large boulder near the water looks like a perfect spot for soaking up sun. If Mordavia had a little more sun.
It is so...
Yes, I know. Calm down, I'm looking
this at things. This is one of the most beautiful women you've ever seen. She has lovely, long, golden green hair. Although your eyesight tends to focus a bit lower than that.
Hector, that's not very good. Let's greet her.
Why don't...
Okay, I think this is all the same. Well, let's try and make friends with her. What do women like? They like flowers, I believe.
Thank you for the beautiful flowers. No one has been so nice to me since I can remember.
Yeah, don't drown us now. That would be bad. Let's see, we'll just take some candy.
That's really very nice of you, but I've been told that too much candy is bad for you.
Okay, but now we can actually, I think,
tell the Rusalka about some of your previous adventures.
Gee, you've done a lot to get rid of monsters and things.
Yes, we have.
You don't think I'm some kind of monster, do you? I mean, just because I'm undead and drown people, you don't think I'm bad.
No, not at all. You're awful. No. Okay, now we can actually ask her about a bunch of things, and she won't respond just by, come into the water. So.
It is lonely being a Rusalka. Anytime anyone nice comes along, I pull him into the lake and drown him. Once he's drowned, he's not much company, I'm afraid.
Probably not. What's your name?
I've been a Rusalka for so long, I've forgotten.
Okay, tell us about the lake then.
This lake is surrounded on three sides by steep mountains. To the southwest, it merges with a swamp. The lake is not a safe place for you to swim. Many unpleasant things lurk in the deep water.
Oh, really? Tell us about
the swamp is definitely a creepy place. Dead things lie under the water and try to drag the living underneath.
Just like...
Kinda sounds like my job description, doesn't it?
Yeah!
Well, the things in the swamp are a whole lot nastier than I am, so be careful out there.
Okay. Thank you. What are these things?
I stay far away from them. They crawled into the lake from the swamp one day. Ugh, they remind me of worms and give me the creeps.
Okay. What can you tell us about the forest?
I don't know much about the forest. I can't leave my lake, so I don't get around there much.
Okay. Why are you here?
You ask what a nice girl like her is doing in a place like this.
I don't really know. I've been here for such a long time now. I mean, it's not like I can go anywhere. I can't leave the lake.
That's not good. What about the drownings?
It's my job to drown anyone who comes to the lake. That's what being a Rusalka is all about.
Well, you don't have to do that job. You could quit. Find another job. I don't know. What about the town?
I think I remember the town. I must have lived there once. Other than the fact it's somewhere to the northeast, I guess I can't tell you much about it.
Okay. Well, at least you are actually talking to us about things, so... We'll definitely have to come back and visit.
Please, come visit me again sometime. It's nice to have a friend to talk to.
Absolutely. Okay, we will return. But that won't be for quite a while, actually. That's pretty much all we can do with the Rusalka for now. So, yeah. Let's just keep... What is it this time? Oh, it's just another rabbit. And I didn't mean to. Okay, I guess I can fight this one myself. Come on, okay. Okay, we took care of that rabbit. And... I don't know where I want to go. There's... Let's see. No, I guess the only place right now to go is back to town. Can talk to Olga again. Then, actually, what time is it? Okay, it's midday. Then I suppose we will wait until it gets a little later. I'll practice climbing a little bit. Then, well, before I actually talk to her, let me come back into the inn, get some food. I haven't had anything to eat today. So, let's sit down, get some food. What is it today?
You eat your plain but nourishing breakfast. It has more...
Just a plain breakfast. Ah, well. Okay. Do you say anything different? Yes, I am back. That all looks familiar, so... Well, let's head up into our room just in case there's something up there. It's possible. I doubt it, but it's possible. Nope. Okay. So now... I will... Probably just... Actually, you know what? I don't think I really need to cut it anymore when I want to wait till night. Because I almost think that... It just keeps letting us do this. I could be wrong, but... Oh, and this is something we haven't seen. Just a nice little touch. Actually shows the Burgomeister closing the window. Okay. So now, let me, head just outside of town. Let me rest once more. And before I cut it, I just want to see if... Maybe something will happen. Ah, yes! Perfect! Perfect!
You have the sensation of someone watching you. You sense curiosity and no immediate danger.
Okay.
It is good to see you again. I hope you are enjoying your visit to Mordavia.
Well, I definitely
am now. You
need
to take better care of yourself, you know?
What?
It is very dangerous out at night.
What? Huh?
Come to me.
Oh.
I have something to show you.
Absolutely. What do you...
I warned you, it is dangerous here at night, and you do not listen.
What?
I intend to teach you a lesson.
What kind of lesson?
A strange feeling sweeps your body.
What is this?
You realize that you now know the frostbite spell.
Perhaps that will help keep you alive when I am not with you.
Why, thank you. Let's greet her.
I bid you welcome to Mordavia. I hope you are enjoying your stay here.
Absolutely.
There. Now you have had an official welcome from your own official welcome woman.
Yes. Let's greet her.
I bid you welcome.
Oh, wait, there. I already did that, didn't I?
You try out a few of your best lines on her.
You flatter me. It is nice to have someone as handsome and attractive as you say such things to me.
Really? Let's actually talk to her. And we've already asked her name. Well, we know her name from before, so let's... what do we want to... Let's talk about the forest.
The forest is a very dangerous place. Many monsters walk here, especially at night. Please... Please be careful.
I will. What kind of dangers are
there? There are monsters everywhere in the forest. I need to get back to the castle where I will be safe.
Oh, back to the castle. Your home?
I live in the castle north of town. It is a cold, dreary place, I'm afraid.
So you live in the castle? Can you tell us anything about it?
I must go now.
Aww.
I hope we can meet again soon. I enjoy your company.
We better meet again soon.
Before you can think to follow her, the young peasant girl has disappeared into the forest.
We didn't get to talk to her that much. Oh, well. I'm sure we'll see her again. What a lovely girl. Okay, I'm gonna cut here for just a little while I do a little bit of climbing practice, so... 1 minute. And I figured I'd just show what I'm doing, just at least once. All I'm doing is just climb, climb, climb. And this is actually probably the easiest and fastest way to practice climbing, because you can just keep clicking on the same spot over and over. Everywhere else, you sort of either have to click on the grappling hook or click in multiple places. Here, everything's just right in line, so it's just repeated clicking. So it goes by quite fast.
You get.
And what is it at, anyways? We are at 184, so we're getting pretty close.
After some rest.
Actually, I don't want to wait too long, so I think I'll stop that practice right now and.
You catch the top of the.
We'll just climb over this way. Because I want to make sure that I get into the inn tonight. Because if we wait too long, we may be unable to beat the game. There's a slight little bug that could happen. So let's knock on the door.
You hear movement.
Okay. And plus, who knows, might be something else to talk about here, and we can get some food and. Oh, there's something actually happening.
Have a seat. Wait, no, better leave the seats here. But why don't you sit down on one? This show can't get on the road until you get off your load. So sit a while and enjoy yourself. Or maybe just sit.
Okay, yes, get ready for a very, interesting little, event. First, let's greet the gnome.
Thank you, thank you. I always like to meet a receptive audience. It's always good to see you. It means you're not behind my back.
Okay, let's introduce ourselves.
Pleased to meet you. I could tell by your outfit that you are no ordinary rube. Punny Bones, the name. Joke's a fair game. I'm a pro punster.
Yes, and I will apologize for all the puns which will be made. It is quite, much.
Hey, I've been looking high and low for you, and I obviously wasn't looking low enough. You trying to upstage me or something?
I'm
show business is tough enough without competition from you. One day they're putting your footprints in cement, and the next day, you're mixing it.
Oh.
So sit down, relax, and catch the show before it gets away.
Okay, okay. Can I at least talk to you, maybe? Okay. Let's. Actually, I'm sure we could actually talk about all this after, but let's do
be
it.
Be ever so humble, there's nobody stays home. I've been on the road so long, I have flat tires on my feet. I go wherever I can tell a good joke, and many places where I can't.
Okay, tell us about.
I'm staying at this inn for a while until I find something here. I got the last door down the hall. Visit me sometime. I'm sure we can have a few laughs together.
Absolutely.
Hey, my last tour was a great success. I outran everyone. But there's no business like show business. With me, the show must go on and on and on.
Why do I have a feeling that is not a good thing?
I got millions of them. Problem is, I can't remember most of them, and the ones I do remember should have been buried long ago. I used to be worth my wit in gold, but oh, it's a long story. Ask me about it some other time.
We will. We absolutely will. So, let's sit down and enjoy the show. And I will keep quiet for most of this.
Good evening, ladies and germs. A funny thing happened on the way to Mordavia. I got here. I walked up to the innkeeper here and says to the guy, "Do you know how lucky you are to have such a funny guy as myself staying here?" The innkeeper says, "No, but if you hum a few bars, I can fake it." You may as well laugh now. This act doesn't get any funnier. I sit down here for a meal and order some soup. When the waiter brings it in, I says, "Waiter, there's a fly in my soup." The waiter says, "Of course, that's the soup du jour." Am I going deaf in here? Or how can so many people sleep with all these lights on? Seriously, folks, I went to the doctor just the other day, and he said he had some good news and some bad news. "What's the good news?" I asked. "You only have 3 months to live," said the doc. "That's terrible. What's the bad news?" I said. The doc replied, "I'm getting married." I know I had an audience when I came in here. Anyhow, show me a guy with 1,000,000 kopecks, and I'll show you a guy who's rich. Hey, you only had to listen to this material. I'm the one who had to stand here and take it. Anyway, thank you, thank you, thank you. You've been a swell bunch of seats.
Phew. The gnome has stopped speaking. Maybe he's finished telling his joke. You think about applauding, but you're not quite sure if you've heard the punchline yet.
What did you think of my performance? Was I hilarious or what?
Is
this an inn or a cemetery? I've had livelier times at funerals. Some help you were. Couldn't you at least have smiled a little louder? It's nights like these that make me feel like an inept idiot and a lousy laughingstock.
Well...
I'd make more money digging graves. But what? And get out of show business?
Yeah... I apologize for that. Okay, let's see what they have to say about him.
He too is a stranger to Mordavia.
Okay.
Hey, what am I, shredded wheat? If you're talking behind my back, at least have the courtesy to do it face to face.
I'm just... fine.
I try to keep people entertained here.
So how come you weren't up on the stage instead of me?
It probably would have been much better, actually, so... yeah.
I have not listened to such nonsense in all my life.
I agree.
You call this a life?
Hey, that was low. That was mean. Okay, what did they have to say? Let's ask about the gnome.
Well, you know I'm not a census taker over here, but there are no other gnomes in Mordavia.
Gnome wonder.
Yeah, when they show up, there goes the neighborhood. We have no need for gnomes here.
You guys are so narrow-minded, you could all look through a keyhole with both eyes. What gnome would want to work here? You guys have all the sense of humor of a wyvern with a hangover.
At the risk of waxing poetic, what need have we of fools?
Hey, you got a point. There are enough fools in here already to reach critical mass. If it pays to be ignorant, why are you guys so broke?
Okay.
Somebody just shoot me.
And just when I was gonna invite you to my party, there's always room for one boar.
I'll tell you, he's rough, you know? Anyone could tell better jokes than that gnome did. Where's Shaky Green when you need him?
Absolutely.
Look, I'd argue with you, but I never engage in a battle of wits with an unarmed man.
The guy's dying up there. I didn't get anything.
That's
hey,
okay.
How could you? If ignorance is really bliss, you're the world's happiest guy.
And the performance.
Fellas, is it just me, or is Shecky's performance here lacking a certain sense of humor?
It's not just you.
Are you kidding? He was rough. Get a day job!
You're right, and he wasn't very funny either.
What do you mean I wasn't funny? You guys wouldn't know a punchline if it hit you in the face!
Oh, that's great. I love those guys. Let's see, does he say anything different? Nope. Okay. So, let's, head up to our room.
You unlock the...
And, I probably should have said goodbye, but... Then let's head back out, and... Let's knock on the door.
A voice from behind the door says, "Oops, sorry. Seems I forgot about my burglar alarm. Hope it wasn't too shocking for you."
And actually, that can kill you. If you have very little life.
Hello, how are you? Come in and have a sit, why don't you?
Okay, why are we...
As you sit down, a rude noise comes from the chair
seat. Get you every time! A million laughs!
A million.
How are you? Good to see you. Nice see you to drop in.
Why am I
speaking of dropping
this?
In, did you hear the one about the bad waiter? Seems like he was always dropping in. Dropping in. Get it? Didn't think so. No one got a sense of humor anymore. Not even me.
No, you don't. Well, let's look at this place. It seems quite interesting.
Somehow just looking at these garlic braids makes you smile. It's a braided, circular rug, just like the one in your room. Only funnier. It makes the perfect cap to the gnome's jester costume.
And that...
The gnome likes to take a quick nightcap before he goes to bed.
And the chair...
The chair has been upholstered with a comfortable-looking thick leather seat.
Let's get the gnome.
The strange comedian you had the misfortune to listen to the other night sits on the bed. He looks at you. with a twisted grin.
Okay, and then...
The chicken seems to be made out of rubber. What's rubber, you ask? You also consider how it would taste cooked in garlic.
Probably great. Let's see. Let's greet him.
Hey, welcome in to the inn. Pleased to meet you. Sit down, have a seat. Oh, we did that already, didn't we?
Yes, we did. Let's tell him about ourselves.
Tell about some of your adventures.
What was that you were saying about saving Spielberg?
Yeah, we saved Spielberg.
Tell about your adventures in Spielberg.
So you're the guy that made me lose my sense of humor.
Wait, what?
Listen, if you hadn't made Baba Yaga mad, I never would have told the joke that made her take my humor away.
Wait. Why am I at fault for... What did I do? We'll talk to him about that. But first, I kind of like this chicken. I want it.
The rubber chicken squeals as you pick it up and squeeze it.
Well, you'll have to keep her now. You obviously rubber the right way. Rubber, get it?
Yes, I get it. Thank you. That's...
You practice the old bop yourself on the head with a rubber chicken routine for a while. It smarts. Worse cluck.
And then let's take a look at it. Where is it? There it is. Rubber chicken. It's the traditional rubber chicken, a stock item for mediocre comedians everywhere. Perfect for us. And I believe...
Keep your hands to yourself. I'm engaged already.
Okay. I thought we could, like, shake his hand and he had, like, a buzzer thing. I guess not. Okay. Let's ask him about humor.
I ain't got no sense of humor. I can't get no sense of humor. And I try, don't know why, gotta fly, say goodbye! What's the matter, you a music critic, so I can't tell a joke? Sue me. I'm comedically challenged. A feeb of a fool. A dweeb dunce. As a matter of fact, I've been cursed. I'm vexed with a hex, so to speak.
I love that, Rolling Stones reference.
Pathetic, ain't it? I can't tell a joke if it kicked me in the teeth. Ever since I got Baba Yaga mad at me, I got the bad joke blues.
So what did you do?
She has no sense of humor whatsoever. Let me tell you, I was just telling a joke about how some hero got Baba Baby hopping mad and fit to be towed. How was I to know she was in the audience at the time? Anyhow, Baba Yaga stands up, says some bad poetry, and the next thing I know is my jokes are jumbled and my puns are pathetic. So here I am in Nowhere Land trying to locate Baba Yaga so as I can get the curse removed and my humor returned.
Wait, she's around here? That's not good.
Putin-tain, ask me again, I'll tell you my name. Seriously, folks, the name is Bones. Punny Bones. I'm just a jester. Professionally speaking, of course. Hey, I'm a professional fool, so don't try this at home, kid. Unfortunately, more people laugh at me than at my jokes lately. It's hard to be hilarious when your sense of humor is defunct.
Yeah, I believe that they laugh at you.
Punny, you should ask about that. Making jokes is in my bones, make no bones about it. But my puns have been sort of boneheaded lately.
Yeah. Tell us about Moldavia.
This place is really dead, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I've had a livelier audience in a graveyard. What do they know about humor? They think a guy falling into a mud puddle is a major joke, like lots of yucks, huh? Now, a man being tripped into a mud puddle, that's comedy.
Gold right there.
What do I hear? Let me see. Well, the talk of the town is you. No one knows how you got here or what are you doing. And they're still all a bit leery of strangers. You should see some of the looks they give me. You'd think they never saw a gnome before. Or you, for that matter.
Okay. I suppose we will say goodbye
to him. Nice to see a friendly face around here. Catch you later, dud.
Yes, we will definitely come back and...
So I ask you, what do you call a dinosaur crashing into a wall?
What?
Late for supper, of course. See you later, crocodile.
Yes. Unfortunately, I believe we have to talk to him again at some point in time. I apologize. Let's see, do they say anything different now that he's gone? Nope. Okay. So let's get something to eat. Then we will actually go to... Or actually, I think it's getting a little... Oh, wait. We don't get any food. Okay. Actually, I think I'm going to stop here because it's getting to be a little bit of a long video. So next time we will hopefully do stuff. Now I have a few ideas of what we will do next time. So I will see you all later.